欢迎各位同学走进南京交通职业技术学院微课堂，我是来自南京交通职业技术学院的马耀文老师。今天由我带领同学们学习冷链货运单元条码。我们知道，冷链供应链中主要涉及消费单元、储运单元和物流单元。之前我们已经学习过了消费单元条码以及储运单元条码，今天我们学习条码在物流单元中的应用。物流单元是指为了便于货物运输管理而形成的单元，通常采用贸易单元128码。下面我们通过一则视频了解货运单元条码。
Meet Ben. He started a jam making business and now it's thriving. Because his jams are so popular,A major retailer has asked him to start supplying his products to them. Due to the large orders they've placed, Ben will have to transport cases of his jam to the retailer on pallets. Ben already identifies his jars and cases of jam with GS1 barcodes and numbers. And now Ben will have to use GS1 barcodes and numbers for all his pallets too.By using the company prefix that he licenses from GS1 Ireland, Ben can create a unique serial shipping container code, or SSCC, for each one of his pallets. The SSCC is then encoded in a specific barcode called a GS1128. Retailers may ask for additional information to be included in the barcode, such as batch numbers and expiry dates.Ben prints these barcodes on labels and applies them to each of his pallets before they leave his factory. There's a standard format for these labels, called a GS1 logistics label, which retailers around the world use. The retailer might also ask Ben for an EDI dispatch advice message. This is an electronic message that provides all the details of Ben's shipment and all the goods it contains.Ben sends the dispatch advice and the shipment directly to the retailer, or more commonly, to their distribution center. When the shipment arrives, the barcode on each pallet is scanned and the SSCC is matched to the dispatch advice. This allows the retailer to update their systems and to store the goods quickly and accurately, which makes it easier for them to then distribute the goods to their shops.Ben can use this same process when he sells to other retailers. And retailers can use the same fast and reliable receiving process for all their suppliers. It means everyone has a precise record of everything that is shipped and received.
一、系列货运包装箱代码。从视频可以看出，为了提高整个冷链供应链的效率，降低物流成本，除了传统的集装货运单元之外，越来越多的生产企业开始使用托盘进行运输，将货物以托盘化运作模式配送到零售商。所以，在整个流通过程中，如何通过使用合适的物流标签追踪整板货物，并进一步打通供应链信息流，是一个重要的问题。在此情况下，GS1 编码标识系统中的 SSCC 编码结构提供了可行的、有效的解决方法。SSCC Serial Shipping Container Code 即系列货运包装箱代码，是为物流单元包括运输或储藏提供唯一标识的代码，对物流单元进行跟踪和记录。 SSCC 用 EAN 或 UCC 系统的128条码符号表示，即贸易单元128码。128码具有全球的唯一性。下面先了解一下系列货运包装箱代码的结构。系列货运包装箱代码是18位的数字代码，由拓展位、厂商识别代码、系列号、校验码组成，有四种编码结构，其中拓展位用于增加 SSCC 系列代码的容量，由厂商分配，其中0代表纸箱运输，1代表托盘，2代表集装箱，3无明确规定，4为内部使用代号，5由供应商与顾客双方定义。 厂商识别代码是由中国物品编码中心负责分配给用户的，用户通常是组合物流单元的厂商。 SSCC 在世界范围内是唯一的，但并不代表物流单元内的贸易项目的起始点。系列代码是由取得厂商识别代码的一个系列号，用 N2 到 N7 字符串，校验位为一位数字，如图中的安慕希。零售单元采用 EAN13 码，代码为 690799251270， 其一级包装也采用 EAN13 码，代码为 690799251276。 物流单元采用 SSCC18 代码结构，用 EAN128 条码标识，代码为 690799200000000011。 同学们，如果在冷链物流贸易双方交接过程当中，要对物流单元有更多的信息标识，比如重量、价格、承运人、收货人、收货地址等，那该怎么办呢？下一课，我们将学习128码对于物流单元附加信息的表达方式。期待同学们的下次聆听，再见。